وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى today we're going to be speaking about أحكام زكاة الفطر. زكاة الفطر is around the corner. We're going to be speaking about the rulings regarding زكاة الفطر. The way that I plan to go through the topic of زكاة الفطر is in 7 steps, inshallah ta'ala, 7 points. The first one is الحكمة من زكاة الفطر. What is the wisdom in why زكاة الفطر was legislated? What's the حكمة? The second, inshallah ta'ala, point is حكم زكاة الفطر. What's the ruling of زكاة الفطر? Is it obligatory? Is it voluntary? What's the ruling? Number 3 is وقت إخراج زكاة الفطر. What is the time and when do we give out the zakat al-fitr? When do we give out the zakat al-fitr? I'm also going to speak about masarif zakat al-fitr. Zakat al-fitr, who are the people that we give it to? Who are the people that the Sharia has commanded us to give it to? That is the fourth. The fifth is asnaf zakat al-fitr. We'll speak about the types of zakat al-fitr there are. We'll speak about that. And number 6 is miqdaru zakat al-fitr. What's the amount of zakat al-fitr that's given? How much does a person have to give? And last but not least, I'm going to conclude with a very important topic, which is hukmu ikhraji zakat al-fitr qima. What is the ruling in giving zakat al-fitr as money instead of food? What is the ruling regarding that? The person doesn't give من غير جنس الطعام, does not give food. So the person in place of that, they give money. What's the ruling regarding that? So those are inshallah ta'ala the 7 points that we shall tackle بإذن الله الكريم regarding زكاة الفطر. The first one is الحكمة من زكاة الفطر. What's the wisdom behind زكاة الفطر? There's many wisdoms behind why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislated زكاة الفطر to be done. Lakin there are two in which the Prophet stated, alayhi salatu wasalam. And these are not the only two reasons. There are more than that. Lakin the first one is طُهْرَةً لِلصَّائِمِ مِنَ اللَّغْوِ وَالرَّفَثِ. The person who's been fasting, who came with fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to purify him. The sa'im, the person who was fasting, Allah is purifying him from any shortcomings, any errors, any mistakes that he might have accumulated in the month of Ramadan. Whether it be slip of the tongue, whether it be speech that was wrong, those little mistakes that came from him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he wants to purify the sa'im, the one who was fasting. The first reason is tuhratan lis-sa'imi. The second reason is wa tu'matan lil-masakin. The poor people, Allah wants to make for them a time and an amount in which they can celebrate Eid with the Muslims. The masakin, they don't have nothing. So Allah is taking the money from them and He's giving it to the masakin so that they can also enjoy Eid with the believers and that they could participate in the happiness and the joy and the excitement with the believers that day of Fitr, Eid al-Fitr. So those two are stated in the hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, in which Abu Dawood narrated in his Sunan wa hassanahu al-Albani rahimahullah. Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah, he graded this hadith to be sound in his kitab Irwa al-Ghalil, and also al-Imam al-Nawiyyu in the Majmu' the Sharah of al-Muhaddab al-Ishaq al-Shirazi, al-Imam al-Nawiyyu also graded it to be hasan, which is that Abdullah ibn Abbas said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, or he said farada rasulullah zakat al-fitr, the Prophet made zakat al-fitr obligatory, tuhratan lis-sa'imi min al-lagwi wal-rafathi, to purify the one who is fasting from shortcomings, errors, foul language, speech. وَطُهْرَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ. And also what? To purify the poor, وَطُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ. And also food for the one who is miskin, poor. The Prophet then said, "Man adaha qabla salati." Anyone who gives it before the prayer of Eid, fahiya zakatun maqbulatun. It's a zakah which is accepted. وَمَنْ أَدَّاهَا And anyone who gives it بَعْدَ الصَّلَاةِ After the prayer فَيَا صَدَقَةُ بِنَ الصَّدَقَاتِ Then all it is a charity from the charities that you give out in the year. And we'll speak about it in more details when we come to the time in which we do it. And then what we took from this is الْحِكْمَةُ مِنْ زَكَاةِ الْفِطْرِ is what, brothers? Two stated by the messenger. The first one is طُهْرَةً لِلصَّائِمِ مِنَ الرَّفَثِ وَاللَّغْوِ And the second one was طُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ Now we're going to go into حكم زكاة الفطر. What's the ruling pertaining to, what's the ruling regarding زكاة الفطر? What's the حكم? زكاة الفطر is فرض عين. It's an individual obligation, meaning every single person has to come with it. فرض عين means everyone has to come with it. فرض كفاية means, فرض كفاية means إذا قام به بعض سقط عن الباقين. If a group of people do it, the rest they don't have to do it. لكن فرض عين means every individual has to do it for what? For himself, no one else takes the obligation of you. And this is based upon what? Based on the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, in which he said, فَرَضَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ زَكَاةَ الْفِطْرِ That the messenger made fitr obligatory. Hanafiyya, madhab al-Hanafiyya, they don't believe that the zakat is fard. They believe it's wajib. And the reason why they say it's not fard and it's wajib, because the Hanafiyya believe that the fard is used when the dalil is qat'i, when the evidence is qat'i. It has reached us through either multitude narration, haddu tawatur, it's large in number, how it reached us, or that it's from the daruriyat, things that we know out of necessity. So if it's not dalilul qat'i, the Hanaf believe it's not called fard, it's called what? It's called wajib, they believe. Lakin we disagree with them in this, because Nabiullah Muhammad said, Abdullah ibn Umar said, sorry, he said, فَرَضَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ And he used the word فَرْض, Abdullah ibn Umar. So, فَرَضَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ زَكَاةَ الْفِطْرِ That Abdullah ibn Umar, he said that the Prophet made it فَرْض زَكَاةَ الْفِطْرِ صَاعًا مِّن تَمْرٍ صَاعٍ is, this is the mud. This is a what? This is the mud of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is mud of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Sa' is four of this, of food. Four times of this is called, is what? It's one mud. Sa' is what? Four mud. This is the mud of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in which he used in Medina. So sa'an means approximately it's 2.6. Lakin, Sheikh Abdulaziz ibn Baz alayhi rahmatullahi, he said, should I make it 2.6, I'm at 2.5 when I estimated it. 2.5 something, to round off 2.6 kilograms. Like Sheikh Abdulaziz ibn Baz, he gave the fatwa that it should be made into three. Why? Because to be on the safe side. Because there's different aqwal. Some are saying, 2.9 something. Some are saying 2.6 something. Some are saying 2.4. Some are saying 2.5. Sheikh Abdulaziz rounded off to three. He said the fatwa, the qarar, and the fatwa that came from him, Hayat Kibar Ulama Lajna Da'ima at his time, was that it's what? It's 3 kilograms. But it's four of this, that's it. That's what. And it's ajeeb, because if you look at the hadith of Anas ibn Malik, the messenger used to do wudu with this. The wudu of the Prophet ﷺ was this, one mud. Are you with me, brothers? And he used to do ghusl with two of this. Two of this was the Prophet's ghusl, iqtisal. Yeah, brothers. The Prophet only used to do ghusl, wash himself with two of this. And he would, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would what? Do wudu with one of this. Imagine those who just run the water. And shower, let the water run. So Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhumah, he said, فَرَضَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ زَكَاةَ الْفِطْرِ صَاعًا مِّن تَمْرٍ صَاعًا, again, it's 3 kilograms, مِّن تَمْرٍ date, أو صَاعًا مِّن شَعِيرٍ, شَعِيرٍ is barley. عَلَى الْعَبْدِ وَالْحُرِّ It's obligatory on what? The slave, and it's obligatory on what? On the free individual. وَالذَّكَرِ وَالْأُنْثَى And it's also obligatory on the male, and it's also obligatory on the female. وَالصَّغِيرِ وَالْكَبِيرِ It's obligatory on the young, and it's also obligatory on what? The elderly individual. مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ From the believers. And then underline that part of the hadith. That the zakatul fitr is obligatory on what? The Muslimin. وَأَمَرَ بِهَا And the Prophet commanded أَنْ تُؤَدَّى قَبْلَ خُرُوجِ النَّاسِ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ And he commanded that it's given before the people go to the prayer. Al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated this hadith من حديث ابن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنهما. Now there's points I want to touch on this hadith. The first one is, what does this hadith tell us? It tells us that the zakatul fitr is obligatory on what? Anyone who's ghani and anyone who's faqir. The faqir has to also give zakatul fitr. The ghani has to give zakatul fitr. Like if the miskin doesn't have to give zakatul fitr, the zakatul fitr goes to him. Then what's the difference between a faqir and a miskin? Sahih? The ghani and the faqir, both of them have to give zakatul fitr. Based on what? Based on the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, because the Prophet generalized it. What did he say? من المسلمين. المسلمين means every Muslim. Are we all together? So if he's a ghani and if he's faqir. Faqir means a person who has his qut yom. He has his daily meal. He has day and night food. But he doesn't have anything out beyond that. This is a faqir. Are we all together? A miskin is the one who doesn't even have a day and a night what to eat. Are we all together, brothers? So anybody, based on this, anybody who has qutul yawm, he has the qut of that day, of Eid al-Fitr, if he has the food to eat that whole day for Eid al-Fitr, 24 hours, he's a what? He is a faqir, he's not a miskin, he has to give zakat al-Fitr. Are we all together, brothers? So zakat al-Fitr is obligatory on the ghani or faqir, because the hadith mentions, ala al-abdi wal-hurri. And the abd is a slave, he doesn't have anything. But what does he have? He has his qut, an abd, the slave. But we will talk about who is the obligatory on. We'll come to it later. The obligation is on the person who is overlooking the slave. So if a slave is over, the master has to give on his behalf. The individual who is free, he has to pay if he's got it from his wealth. ولذلك الإمام الشوكاني mentions in his نيل الأوطار, he says وهذا هو الحق. This is the truth. لِأَنَّ النُّصُوصَ أَطْلَقَتْ Because the nusus spoke unrestrictedly. It said, عَلَى الْعَبْدِ وَالْحُرِّ On the slave and on the free one. It made it unrestricted. And it did not, he said, and it did not specify غَنِيًّا أَوْ فَقِيرًا Shawkani is saying this. He didn't specify the Prophet ﷺ, the rich from the poor. So every one of them have to give it. Another point that I want to take from the hadith is, the one who gives it is the one who is providing for them. عَلَى الْعَبْدِ وَالْحُرِّ وَالصَّغِيرِ وَالْكَبِيرِ The صغير is the young child. The young kid doesn't have money to give. But he has his qut. He has his daily income. Yes, it's on him. But who does it become obligatory on? It becomes obligatory on the person who's providing for him. The father is obligatory on him. He has to give it from them. The scholars, they differed. Does the husband have to pay for his wife? The qawl is mukhtalif. Lakin the qawl which is rajih is that he has to pay. The qawl which is strong is that the husband has to pay for his wife unless she's rich and she has her own money. But if the man is the one who has the money and he provides for his wife, then he has to pay for her. That's the qawl which is rajih. أما الجنين في البطن As for the child in the stomach who's not born yet, then فَلَا يَجِبُ إِخْرَاجُ الزَّكَاةِ Zakat is not obligatory on him. Ibn al-Mundhir rahimahullah brought an ijma' in that masala. Al-Imam Ibn al-Mundhir rahimahullah, he brought an ijma' in his kitab that it's not obligatory to give for the one who is in the womb of the mother to give zakat for him. He said it's not. Rather, it's not even a sunnah asla. It's not even a sunnah to give it, let alone wajib. And this hadith that the scholars use, the hadith of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, then go to Irwa' al-Ghalil, the third mujallad. You'll find Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah weakened it. Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah weakened it. The fourth point that I want to mention regarding this issue is that the zakatul fitri, it's obligatory on the one who is fasting and the one who is not fasting. So if the wife, the woman was on her postnatal bleeding, she just gave birth to a child. And so it happened that she didn't fast for the whole month of Ramadan because the postnatal bleeding can go for how long? For 40 days. So for those 30 days of Ramadan, she did not fast. And she is in that state, it is still upon her to pay the zakatul fitri. It's obligatory on her. Based on the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, where he said that it is obligatory upon ala sagiri wal kabiri. Is the sagir obligatory on him to do fasting? No, the young kid doesn't have to fast. The sagir doesn't have to fast. So he's most likely not fasting in Ramadan, but the zakat is still obligatory for it to be paid on his regard. So is the woman who's in her postnatal bleeding. It has to be paid for her as well. Now we move on to the third point, which is waqtu iqraj zakat al-fitr. When does the zakat al-fitr have to be given? When does the zakat al-fitr have to be given? The time of the zakat al-fitr being given, we divide it into three times. Three separate timings. The first one is waqtul jawaz, a time when it's permissible for you to give it if you want to. You're allowed to if you wish so, it's up to you. And this is based upon the hadith of Nafi' Mawla ibn Umar. Nafi' Mawla ibn Umar, he said, وَكَانُوا دَيْوَى. Who is he referring to? He's referring to the companions, the Sahaba. كَانُوا يُعْطُونَ. They used to give, قَبْلَ الْفِطْرِ. They used to give, the companions used to give the zakatul al-fitri before Eid, بِيَوْمٍ أَوْ يَوْمَيْنِ, 1 or 2 days before it. So the time that is permissible for you to give it is 2 days, 1 day before it, a day or two. You're allowed to give it. So you're allowed to give it on the 28th, if the month is 30, okay? And on the 29th, if the month is 30. But if the month is what, 29, you can give it on the 27th, and you can give it on the 28th. This is permissible for you to do, based on the fact that the companions used to do it, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam consented to it. Iqraran minhu sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Iqrar means what? He consented. He didn't stop them from that action that they were doing. So if the person gives the zakatul fitr a day or two before it, there's no problem. That's waqtul jawaz. You're allowed to, no problem. The second timing is the waqtul wujub, the time when it's obligatory to give. The second time is called waqtul al wujub. You have to give it. This starts yabda'u. It begins bi ghurub ash-shamsi, when the sun sets. Maghrib, the day when the Ramadan Eid is announced, and the Taraweeh is not prayed that night, and the Tahajjud is not prayed, and tomorrow is Eid. From Maghrib, when they notify that tomorrow is Eid, from that time until what? The beginning of Salatul Eid is the obligatory time which you have to give. Starting from the Ghurub al-Shams, the night, the sun setting the day before Eid, the night before Eid, وَيَنْتَهِي بِابْتِدَاءِ صَلَاةِ الْعِيدِ, and it ends before the khutbatul jum'ah, khutbatul Eid starts. I mean, sorry, the Salatul Eid starts, sorry. Before the Imam says, Allahu Akbar, then it's finished. That timing is called waqtul wujub, the person has to give it. The third time is afdalul waqti, the best time to give it. The best time to give it is ba'da salatil fajri, after salatil fajri, on the Eid day, after Fajr until Salatul Eid. In between that time you give it. That you go and you give it. That is the best time, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he specifically mentioned that timing. What did the hadith say in Sahihain? That the Prophet amaraha, the Prophet commanded and to adda, that it's given قبل خروج الناس إلى الصلاة, before the people go to the prayer. And even though it says amara, he commanded, this one it means على وجه الأفضلية, ليس على وجه الإلزام. It's in a recommended manner, not forceful manner. That it's recommended that the afdaliyah, this time it's the best time that the person can give it. Shafi'iyah believe that you're allowed to give it at the beginning of Ramadan, the first day of Ramadan, when Ramadan is announced. Shafi'iyah say you can give it, or they say you can give it in the middle of Ramadan. Any time within Ramadan, they say you can give zakat al-fitr. That's what they say. لكن هذا اجتهاد منه. هذا اجتهاد منهم. That's an اجتهاد from the أئمة الشافعية. That's a personal independent reasoning which they came with. لكن there is no evidence to strengthen and to strengthen that opinion. Rather, the evidences are not in support of that. All that we have, the earliest is a day or two. And this is عبادة and عبادة توقيفية. It's a عبادة, and a عبادة is what? Tawqifiyah, meaning it requires evidence for you to give it. So the person is not allowed to give it. أَمَّا إِذَا كَانَ جَاهِلًا. As for if the person is ignorant and is unaware of it, and he does give it, and he takes the call of Shafi'i, and he does happen to give it at that time, then inshaAllah ta'ala will say, the zakat is inshaAllah ta'ala, you've taken the responsibility and the obligation of yourself. Like, and it was not upon you to do it like that. It was not something you should do. Another point that I want to mention is anybody who gives the zakatul fitri ba'da salatul eidi, he gives it after salatul eidi, muta'ammidan, deliberately, he chooses to deliberately do that, then this person, he becomes a sinner for doing this. He becomes a what? A sin for doing this. And it will not be rewarded from him. Meaning the zakatul fitri is not going to be, accepted from him. It's not going to be accepted from him. And based on the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, what did he say? فَيَا صَدَقَةٌ مِنَ الصَّدَقَاتِ. He said, وَمَنْ أَدَّهَا بَعْدَ صَلَاتِ فَيَا صَدَقَةٌ مِنَ الصَّدَقَاتِ. Anyone who gives it after the salah, the Prophet said, it becomes a sadaqah from the sadaqat. So it's just a what? A sadaqah that you gave. But the question is, هَلْ يَسْقُطُ أَدَاءُ زَكَاةُ الْفِطْرِ. Like, does the obligation of zakatul fitri be uplifted from your shoulder if the person does delay it after the salah? Then we say no. This is a debt. And this debt is the right of the masakeen. It's like you took money from somebody and you delayed the time of giving them back their debt. It doesn't go off your shoulder. Are you with me? This is a debt that the masakeen have on you. So the person has to still give it. فَيَدَيْنٌ عَلَيْهِ لِلْمَسَاكِينَ. It's debt that the masakeen have on you. لا يسقط عنه إلا بأدائه. And it will not be uplifted from you unless you give it. Al-Imam Ibn Hazm rahimahullah, he mentions this in his Kitab Al-Muhalla, the 6th volume, page 143. And Ibn Qudama mentions it in his Kitab Al-Mughni, which is a sharah of Mukhtasar Al-Khiraqi. He mentions it in the 2nd volume, page 672. Now we're going to move on to, we spoke about what? وقت إخراج زكاة الفطر. We're now going to speak about مصارف زكاة الفطر. We're now going to speak about مصارف زكاة الفطر. Zakatul Fitri, who is it given it? Who is it given to? Zakatul Fitri is given to the masakeen. This is a nas from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Clearly and categorically the Prophet said it. Based on the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. Ibn Abbas' hadith. He said, Farada Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam zakatul fitri. The Prophet made zakatul fitri obligatory. Tu'matan lil-masakeen. Lil-masakeen. And what did he say a maskeen is? Miskin is man la yajidu quta yawmihi. He's the person who can't find the food of that day. So anyone who doesn't have the food for that day is a miskin. The food goes to him. Abu Dawud narrated the hadith wa hassanahu al-Albani rahimahullah. Like in the scholars they mention, if a person is miskin and it's given to him, can he then give zakatul fitr from it as well? So gave somebody, the food was given to him. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah mentions this in his Majmu' al-Fatawa. That zakatul fitr is given to him. Can he then choose, if he wants to get reward, he can give the zakat al-fitr? We'll say to him, na'am, the reward is with him. He will get rewarded for it and he's allowed to do that. But he's not allowed to make it an agreement between him and a group of people, he says, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah. Where he goes to a group of people and he says, I'll give to you, you give to him, and we all give and bring it back to me like that. Where he gets the money back and he wants to get the reward for it. Huh? He says, this is not permissible. And he mentions this in his kitab, Bayanu al-Dalil fi Butlan al-Tahlil Azwar, rahimahullahu ta'ala. So zakatul fitri is different from zakatul badan. There's two types of zakat, brothers. There's zakat called zakatul mal, and there's zakat called zakatul badan. Zakatul mal, there's something that's required, there's a nisab. There has to reach the nisab. And there are asnafun thamaniya, three types of people that you have to give it to. Sah innama as-sadaqatu lil-fuqara'i. والمساكين والعاملين عليها والمؤلفة قلوبهم والغارمين في والغارمين وفي سبيل الله وابن السبيل صح وفي الرقاب وابن السبيل. Those are the types, the ثمانية أصناف that the person has to give it. Other than the مسكين, the عاملين عليها والمؤلفة قلوبهم and وفي الرقاب والغارمين and وفي سبيل الله وابن السبيل, all of those are for the zakatul mal. The only one that is for the zakatul fitri is the miskin. And we all together. Zakatul mal, you give the other seven types. Like in the miskin, here is specific for the zakatul fitri. And it is not permissible for you to give it to the other types that are mentioned in that ayah. Because this is not what, brothers? It's not zakatul mal. What is it? This is zakatul badan. This is what? It's zakatul badan. You don't give it. Lakin, Al-Imam al-Shawkani rahimahullah, he mentions, and also Ibn al-Qayyim Zad al-Ma'ad, that if the person cannot find a miskin to give it to, then they can follow the asnaf al-thamaniya. You can give it to any of those eight types. If you can't find a miskin to give it to. and there's no miskin in your land, then you're allowed to give it to any of those asnaf in tamaniya you could give it to, if you can't find it. Now I want to speak about asnafu zakat al-fitri. The zakat al-fitr, what is it that we give? What can a person give out? The zakat al-fitr that a person gives, it has to be ta'am al-adamiyin, food that the human beings can eat. Children of Adam, the food that they can eat is what the zakat al-fitr is done with. فَيُخْرِجُ الْمُزَكِّي, the one who is doing the zakat, he gives sa'am min ta'am, he gives a sa'a, 3 kilograms, ama 4 mud of what? طَعَامُ غَالِبُ قُوتُ بَلَدِهِ, your country that you're in, what is it that the people eat? What is the well-known food that the people of your balad eat? Whatever that they eat is the food that you give for the what? For the zakat al-fitri. So you give طَعَامُ غَالِبِ قُوتُ بَلَدِهِ, the land that you're at, the thing that the people eat is what you give it. If the people of that land don't eat dates, that's not what they eat, then bringing them that food is no value for it. And this is the qawl of the jumhur al-ulama. This is the qawl of the majority of the scholars, and they use the istidlal of hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri. The hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri is the evidence that they used, in which he said, كُنَّا نُخَرِّجُ فِي عَهْدِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يوم الفطر صاع من طعام أو صاع من شعير أو صاع من تمر أو صاع من أقط أو صاع من زبيب وكان طعام الشعير والزبيب والأقط والتمر. أبي سعيد الخدري mentioned the hadith صحيح البخاري. He says at the time of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم we used to give out صاع من طعام. Another riwayah mentions صاع من شعير. صاع, we already mentioned it. How much is of this is صاع? 4 of this, ama 3 kilograms, ama the palm twice of the hand of an ordinary person. Okay, all of those are aqwal of the ulama. So sa'an min sha'ir, sha'ir is barley, or sa'an min tamrin, or a sa' of what, dates, or sa'an min aqitin, aqitin is a cottage cheese, or sa'an min zabibin, a zabib is dried grapes, meaning raisins, right? Look what then he said, Abi Sa'id al-Khudri at the end. وَكَانَ طَعَامَ الشَّعِيرُ وَالزَّبِيبُ وَالْأَقِطُ وَالتَّمْرُ طَعَامُنَا, he said. Our food in Medina was الشَّعِيرُ وَالزَّبِيبُ وَالْأَقِطُ وَالتَّمْرُ. That's what we used to eat. In other words, he's trying to say that the food that we used to give out in Zakat in Medina was the food that we used to eat. Are we all together, brothers? So the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri shows that the food that the people eat is what the person should give out in terms of Zakat al-Fitri. That is what should be the masarif, asnafu zakat al-fitri that the person chooses to give. Another point is the miqdaru zakat al-fitri, the amount. I already mentioned that. The amount, the scholars, they differed on it. Like in the qawl which we strengthened and we proved, is that the zakat al-fitri is done based upon 4 of the mud. Like in which mud specifically, the mud that we applied it on is mud ahli al-Madina. And this is the mud of ahli al-Madina. This is the mud of the people of Medina. And it's important. Well, what's the evidence for that? Imam al-Nasa'i narrated in Sunan wa Sahih al-Albani rahimahullah that the Prophet said, Al-Mikyalu Mikyalu Ahli Medina. That the Prophet said, the scaling is the scaling of the people of Medina. Wal-Waznu ala Wazni Ahli Makkah. So the measurement is the measurement of the people of Medina. And the scaling is the scaling of people of Makkah. The measurement is what? The people of Medina, and the scaling is the people of Mecca. The food is 2 types, sah? That which is measured and that which is scaled, right? So those 2 types, the Prophet ﷺ broke it for the people of Mecca and the people of Mecca. Then when we say that sa'an, whenever we hear it, we refer to the sa' of Ahl Medina, because sa' is a kail. Are we all together? And we already spoke about the amount that it is. Now we're going to go into the last point, which is حكم إخراج زكاة الفطر قيمة. Are you allowed to give the زكاة الفطر as money? Can somebody give money instead of food? I don't want to give food, it's too much time. Can I just give out money? Or anything other than that, clothing, and etc. Can a person do that? The strongest opinion is لا يجوز زكاة إخراج زكاة الفطر قيمة. You're not allowed to. Whether it be clothing or money, it's not permissible. And that's the strongest الراجح من أقوال أهل العلم, the strongest opinion regarding the scholars what they've said. And if a person does that, لا تجزي عنه, it doesn't, it's not accepted from you. You have to still be, give the zakat. لأسباب آتية, for the following reasons. Number one is الأصل في العبادات التوقيف. عبادات التوقيفية. عبادات is that you can't do something unless you have what? Unless you have evidence for it, you're not allowed to do it. Who said you can do something which you don't have evidence for? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, من عمل عملا ليس عليه أمرنا فهو رد. Anyone who does an action that's not from our affairs is rejected. Then it won't be accepted. It's not from the actions of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. And the person can fall under, فليحذر الذين يخالفون عن أمره أن تصيبهم فتنة أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم. Also, the giving of money is in opposition to the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the way of the Khulafa al-Rashideen. It's not something which they have done. They rather gave food specifically. That's what's found from them. All of the time that they could have given money, they specifically chose to give food. So if you're giving money, the money was there at that time and they chose not to give it. Number three is that the zakat that's given, Salatul Fitri, if the person gives it to them money, what's he going to do with it that day when he needs to do something? What is he going to do with it on the Eid day when he needs food? What's paper going to do for him? Scholars, they said it defeats the purpose of what the Zakatul Fitr was made for. It was something for him to eat. It was made for something for him to eat. Also, this is the qawl of the Jamaheerul Aridati min Ahlil Ilm. The overwhelming majority of scholars, they said this, that the Zakatul Fitr has to be given as food. The only one who opposed the A'immatul Arba'a is Abu Hanifa. Al-Imam Malik rahimahullah, if you go to the Mudawwanatul Kubra, Al-Imam Malik rahimahullah, Nassun Sarih, that he mentions rahimahullah, that it's what? That the Zakatul Fitr has to be food. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, if you go to the Majmu' by Nawawi, or if you go to the Kitab al-Umm, Riwayat al-Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi, of Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, Shafi'i also categorically and clearly says that it has to be food. Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah in Mughni by Ibn Qudama, he mentions that it has to be with food. Rather, Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, they said to him when he said it has to be with food, but they said Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, he doesn't give it out with food. He gives it out with money. And then Imam Ahmad said the following. He said, يَدَعُونَ قَوْلَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. They leave off the speech of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَيَقُولُونَ قَالَ فُلَانُ وَفُلَانُ. And they tell me if so and so said. Who so and so? Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. Imam al-Tabi'in, is the Imam of the Tabi'in. Ahmad said, rahimahullah ta'ala, I say to them, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يَدَعُونَ قَوْلَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. They leave off the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم's speech. ويقولون قال فلان وفلان. And then he said قال ابن عمر. He said ابن عمر, and he said فرض رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He mentioned the hadith that we mentioned before. And then he said that وقال الله تعالى أن الله سيد وأطيع الله وأطيع الرسول. Imam Muhammad said رحمه الله. And then he said وقال قوم يردون السنن قال فلان وقال فلان. And then he said people who choose to reject the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم will say to you قال سو فلان قال فلان. نعم. So you can see the Salaf رحمهم الله were harsh when it came to ahadith. ولذلك Ibn Abi Dhi'b bin rahimahullah, he heard that Imam Malik, he doesn't accept the majlisul khiyari bay'ah, that the person has al-bay'ani bil khiyari ma lam yatafarraqa. Malik doesn't believe this. Ibn Abi Dhi'b bin, he said, Malikun yustatabu illa duriba unuquhu. He said Imam Malik is told to repent from that view. Wa illa duriba unuquhu, oh, his head has to be struck. That's Imam Malik rahimahullah. That's Imam Malik rahimahullah. And then Ahmed was told this. Ahmed was told, rahimahullah, the qawl of Ibn Abi Dhi'b bin that he said about Malik. And then he said, Ibn Abi Dhi'b bin awra' wa atqa wa a'lam min Malik fi dhalik. He said he's more pious and he's more knowledgeable and he's more accurate. And then Dhahabi said, ala bin Ubala, he said, in kara wari'an. If he's truly wari', Dhahabi is saying this about who? Ibn Abi Dhi'b bin. He said, if Ibn Abi Dhi'b, Ahmed, if he's truly wari', he would have not said something like that about Malik. He says in the Sirah. Ala kulli hal, what we take from this, brothers, is that كل يؤخذ من قوله ويرد إلا صاحب هذا القبر. Everybody's speech is between al-akhdh wal-rad, acceptance and rejection. There's nobody whose speech is not who's not on that scale. Only person whose speech we don't reject, we have to accept, we have to submit to, we have to follow, is Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's a summary, a very, 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 very summarized explanation of Zakatul Fitr. I didn't want to lengthen it too much. And I finished the 7 points that I wanted to go through. The 7 points were Al-Hikmatu min Zakatul Fitr, Hukmu Zakatul Fitr, Waqtu Ikhraji Zakatul Fitr, Masarifu Zakatul Fitr, Asnafu Zakatul Fitr, Miqdaru Zakatul Fitr, and last but not least, Hukmu Ikhraji Zakatul Fitr, Qima. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are truly free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.